Here's what I want to do in this video. I'd like to be able to control the length of the serif with a variable. So I can move between sans serif and serif letters and then also be able to control the length of it. To start, I will first need to draw this base shape, which I will use begin shape and end shape. And this is a very simple example. We only need four different vertices. And I have set my canvas to 200 by 400 pixel. And each unit in this grid, I will treat it as 20 by 20 square. So the first vertex, which I will start from bottom left and go clockwise. So that'll be x80 and y380. So I'm gonna move up to the top left corner. X will be the same, but y will be just 20. Continue on, 120 and 20. The last one will be 120 and 380. So let me run this sketch. So you can optionally close when you call end shape function. So that will close a gap. But in this case, it doesn't really matter much because we will be using just the fill color. Okay, we're done. And let's move on to this shape and see how we can move between these two different shapes. But I don't want to just turn on and off this serif. Rather, I want this serif to sort of grow out of it, grow out of sans serif. So the change will be continuous. And if you compare these two different letter forms, probably I will need more information, like this corner. So although this shape looks like it only needs four different vertices, in fact, I need to give four extra ones for each corner to define the serif. So that's what I'm going to do. I can keep the previous four vertices, but I'm going to add more. But we just have to be careful where we add them in, right? So starting with this one, first one is already defined, which will become a serif. It can sort of extend and shrink left and right. But then I need one more point, this one here. So here I will add the comment for the first one, will become a serif, moving left. And after that, I will need another one, 20 pixels up in y direction. And obviously we will not see any differences, but you will see if I move x, decrease it, then that's my serif, which later I will connect to a variable. And then going up in this direction, I need another point here. And this becomes another serif on top, also moving to the left. And the next one is another serif, moving to right, this one. And I will need another one right below it. So vertex 120 and 40. Let me do some testing just so I don't make any mistakes. Oops. Like this, it works. And serif to the left, like this, and it works. So moving on, so that's the serif moving to the right. And I need another extra one at the bottom, right here. So that'll be 120 and 360. And this vertex also becomes serif that's going to grow to the right. So I define all 8 points, and only thing left to do is connect a variable. So I'm going to create a local variable right here, const. Let's just call it serif length. And for now, I'll just start with 10. And we'll update the shape functions by adding this variable. The first one, to move this vertex to the left, that's all about x-axis. So in this case, we don't need any y movement. So only thing that we'll be updating will be in the x direction. So starting from 80, if the serif gets longer and if it needs to move to the left, then I will need to subtract. So we got the one down at the bottom and moving to the top one, which I will also need to subtract. But on the other half, As the serif grows, we will need to extend to the right, which means in terms of this coordinate system we have, we need to add. And so we're done. So we can test some values, like a 30 pixel, or what happens if I even go to the negative range, negative 20? That's kind of fun too. Let me put it back to 20. And instead of just changing number every time we run the sketch, we can also make it a bit more interactive. And you know how we tried connecting mouse X and Y in earlier videos. So let me try mouse X. Now if I move my mouse cursor into the canvas, then I can grow and shrink. And again, if it seems too much, you can do a simple division. Or you can use map or constraint functions. So that's the basic concept, but let's do another example for practice. This one is a little more complex, uppercase F. The difference here is that we not only have serif growing left and right, but here's a serif that's moving vertically up and down as well. And we also learned from the previous example that we can't just define these points from the sans serif letter, but we also need some extra points. So how about we just start with this one? So I'm going to comment all of these out and start fresh. Begin shape, end shape. So I'm going to start from the bottom left here. But you can see this point, I'm not exactly sure where this fits in because it's somewhere in the middle of my pixel grid. So let me do a little simple editing just to reset all the design. But keep in mind, we'll need to still add these extra points anyways. But I'll just reset them all. I mean, you don't have to do this, but I think this simplifies my plotting process a lot better. So first one, 20, 380. I'll just keep going and you can follow along. I'm not done with the plotting all the vertices, and also I made some notes for myself just so I know in which direction serif should be moving. Then all that's left to do is reusing the same variable we created earlier, this serif length, and just connect to different places. So first one here, because I made some comments for myself, I don't need to look at my drawing again and sort of guess and figure out where and which direction everything should be moving. I'll just follow my notes here. So that'll be subtracting serif in X direction. Same thing here. In this case, that's a little tricky, right? Because serif here, this one, is growing in Y direction. But we can still use the same variable we created because it just becomes a number. So just make sure it's growing in Y direction. Same here, in Y direction, but by subtracting it. The last one will be growing in X direction. And if my plan was all correct, it should work just fine. So let me check that out with the mouse interaction. Okay, it looks like it's working just fine. And I like to display two letters all at the same time. So let me uncomment the previous uppercase I shape. And of course, they all sort of overlaps, which is expected because I was using the same origin point from 0, 0 here. So for now, I'll do something that I haven't talked about in my videos, which is a translate function. And we'll talk more about this in the future videos, but for now, let's just do this. We'll translate by 200 pixel to the X and 0 pixel to the Y. and then change the canvas size back to 400 by 400 so that I can see both shapes at the same time. And our variable is working beautifully. And if you click hold and go all the way to the left, you can also look at what effect it has in the negative range of values. So that's all I have for this video. And I think it'll be really helpful if you can maybe continue with this and think about adding even few more variables. We only use one, but can you maybe control the thickness of the serif, as in slab serif typefaces? Then you will need to introduce another variable, right? Or try a very custom looking serif shape as well. So try adding maybe one or two variables to shape the serif even further. And I'll see you in the next video.